Thank you. Thank you. And we are back for match two of the day. I got the semifinals of Division C between the winner of last match. Hold on, I have my own sound on. Give me a second. Forgot to mute stream. Good job, me. Anyway, back. Semifinals. Winner from last match, Sibs. Versus Ghetto Otaku. Troy of Athens. For a lowercase t. But it's all good. Same difference, really. Doesn't matter too much. Okay, we've started. Apologies that we can't get stats for last match right now. It's I can't exactly do them while simultaneously watching and making sure that live is going well. So yeah, we're just gonna keep going and know that we won because we all saw it just happen just now. So. Anyone wants any stats people want to do this stuff right now? Just gonna go off of what we all saw because it happened. It's real. Okay, Ghetto failing left side. I'll double check what seed he is. What seed Ghetto is. Yeah, Ghetto's seed 8. Okay, yeah, it just got switched live. Cool. Checking the back end to see if I can figure out why head-to-head isn't working. Yeah, I still don't know how the back end works. This stuff is magic. Oh, that might do it. Thank you. Never mind, I'm gonna stop trying. Okay. Cool. Oh, wait, I fixed it somehow. I'm a genius. Don't worry about me. I figured it out, I guess. Heads out, it's working on the sheet. I did it. Okay, now that I'm done figuring out stat stuff on the sheet, I can go back to watching the actual race and commentating it. Okay, so Sib's finishing out Cascade with a 540. And then Karawataku with a, looks to be a 551. Okay, get Otaku doing a manual DSDI. Nice twitch menuing stuff going on. Oh, I just realized Ghetto Otaku doing a reverse town. Wish there was a short way of saying it, because I don't know if he wants to go by Ghetto or Otaku. Both are not... Oh. I'm just gonna stick with... Oh, okay. Cypher in chat saying Ghetto, so I'm actually gonna go with Ghetto. Oh, missing the Hano Bird. Solid Sandram setup for Sibs. And so I'm not doing a platform clip. Looks like Ghetto doesn't think it's gonna land, and it is not. It's a no plaque clip from either player. of Taku falling down. Gonna use the bullet bill to get back up and get the moon instead. Solid backup, honestly. All things considered. A nice single spin throw. Sibs did just do a race against Marcus. And they, I guess they agreed that the winner would immediately do the semifinals right after. This is just what they set up. Ghetto making sure to stay hydrated. Gonna have Sibs exiting sand with a 1039. And Ghetto with 11-13. And yeah, we talked. I see that. Sibs currently on pace with their PB. So this is just, honestly, I'm curious if they're having. I can't find their average. I don't know how to do this on the run. I'm sure it's here. I'm sure I could figure it out. There we go. I found average. Yeah, their average is 1039, so they're 9 seconds ahead of their average right now. Wait, no, I'm dumb. Oh, okay, they're 9 seconds ahead of their. I am dumb. Hold on a sec. I know what's happening. They got a 1039, and for average, they are 9 seconds ahead of that. So I guess their average is at like a 1048. Yeah, exactly. All right. Well, Sib's going to be exiting. I think that was 1358. Had some trouble with the clip. I'm not even sure if they went for it. I was too busy looking at stats. Ghetto getting a 14-14, currently a 15-second difference. Almost 16 seconds. Okay, Sib setting up for an upclip. Looking alright. Ooh, missing the moon? And gonna fall! No! Oh! Is that a Deepwood's fall? That's a Deepwood's fall! Oh no! Okay, Ghetto onto the intermediate route. Sib's not going to be going for any moons while getting thrown down here. Just going to take a vine up and out of here. But that's a very large time loss. We'll put Ghetto in the lead. Yeah, and sticking to the intermediate route is definitely the safer move at this level. Ghetto has to redo FRS. Gonna be, yeah, throttle plan FRS. Ghetto not fighting Spirit. Gonna be bouncing off of the robot there. Come on. Okay, doing a solid pipeway so far. Let's see if Ghetto can get the cycle. Looks good. And yeah, it's going to exit Wooded with the lead. Yeah, that was my guess for Otaku as well. Is that I forget it as well. It's just going to be whatever they're used to. Sibs entering pipeways. Ghetto starting up the cloud fight. Oh, gets a yoink. And with a solid lead now, 56 seconds out of Wooded, and looking to maintain that out of Cloud. Pretty much an ideal Bowser fight. Finds it just a little flub at the start. So should be we'll make up a couple seconds, but nothing too significant compared to the overall gap. Get out with this successful meme tree. I'm playing it safe for the butterfly, not doing any double jumps or anything. With the meme tree as well. They got into this kingdom with a 49 second gap. Sibs opting for the fast way of getting the butterfly. Does it successfully. And does it successfully. I can't say that word for some reason. And no cage triple from Ghetto, just gonna be going for Stone Cage. Oh, and gets the Deathless as well. Ooh, Sib's not gonna be able to break open the block for with Torpedo, gonna have to use Torpedo a second time. No cage triple for Sibs either. Oh, Get out of having a smooth night, night metro so far. And exited Lost Gina, by the way, with a 47 second gap. Oh, Sib's bonking on the awning jump. Kind of being extra safe with City Hall. Jump. Okay, Ghetto wants a cycle two for the Mech Wiggler. Should be able to do this. Is this Hangman? I'm gonna have Hangman. Gets a two cycle. Okay, let's see what pattern Sibs gets. Yeah. Oh, eliminating four of the fireballs. Gonna make... Not gonna give them a lot of time as they are dealing with... Mushroom? Do you think that's mushroom? I think it's called mushroom? I don't know. I don't recognize that pattern. Ooh, Ghetto with the early capture on the pole. And then not going to be able to get the pole jam at all. Sid's having a little bit of trouble getting inside of the girder. Sib starting off the game musicians. Nice down throw into the dumpster. Oh, Sib's not going to be able to make it to the dumpster. Going to have to take the checkpoint flag back up. And into blind jump. And Gera gonna be leaving Day Metro with 32-24. Okay, Ghetto with the early shot. Gonna be going to, showing that they're probably gonna go to Rando Room and obviously not doing ICC. Sib's leaving plenty of snow for Captain Toad. Not going to be able to do the snow clip on Ghetto from Zachary's side. By the way, now we've got a 1 minute and 5 second lead for Ghetto Otaku. Nice spiny manipulation. Mm-hmm. don't think that snow clip's gonna work. Okay, it did work, actually. Is gonna be able to use it and save a second. Is a bit off cycle. Good bonk into the poison with a bad rolling line. As Ghetto moving through the Goomba room. Gets the cycle this time around using that triple jump into the Typhoo. Alright, let's see how Snowdram works out for Sibs. Looks good. Able to land that. Nope, no issues here. Having a 109-second lead for Ghetto Otaku out of Snow Kingdom due to that death that Sibs had in the Typhoo room. But getting a Snowdram on first try does make up some time loss this gap would have been even larger if it wasn't for getting that Snowdram. First try. Oops, Sib's gonna be bonking, not quite making the jump for the first moon in Seaside. you know, exiting Seaside out of 40-51. So it's gonna have to redo fish clip. And Ghetto not getting enough height on the salt jump. Sibs exiting Seaside, 42-16. So, 1 minute, 25 second gap. Did grow a little bit due to some mess ups fish clip. Probably a little bit more as well, but I'm not entirely sure what else caused increase in the gap. Ghetto heading into fourth room. Or getting the moon. Okay, Ghetto capturing the meat. Ghetto leaving luncheon. Got 47:34. He's getting within range of their PB. Currently only 6.5 seconds ahead. Let's go, Lucine, the goat. Getting stats going in the background, thank you. Still don't have stats for the last match, but very appreciated with all you can do this game. Ghetto left, leaving wooded here, ruined here with a 50-53, 4.5 seconds ahead of PB, or behind PB, 4.5 seconds behind. Lucine, you could have ignored my commentary issues, but you chose to say something. get it. I make mistakes. I say words wrong. Happens. See, it's gonna be an exiting ruined. Getting 52-17. So a 1:24 lead right now for Ghetto. Ghetto bringing out the down throw strats for shards. Not using the optimal down throw shards, but still takes advantage of it. Looks like a good Bowser's Ram. Makes it. Ghetto representing the Topper First gang. And so is Sibs. Lucene, I think you just gotta accept that you're wrong today. I just captured a fly with one hand. I wish that was on recording. I legitimately just did that. The one time I wish I had a webcam, that was kind of crazy. Oh, Ghetto gonna be falling down from Mecha Brutal. Still in the middle of this first part, you actually can still be trying on the Burgle's front line. Yeah, the Mechavirtle kind of just stays in this stasis until you capture a bird. It's kind of weird. Not even capture a bird until you throw a bomb at it. It doesn't really move anywhere the first time around. So, luckily, able to still pull off a birdless climb. And other than a rough start, actually gonna have a pretty solid Mechabrutal. Okay, Sips, target acquired. Able to make it work, nice. Ghetto getting a 59-13 for Bowser's exit. Now 16 and a half seconds behind PB. BPT of 104.33. Would have to get a 5.10 to PB, which is 17 seconds better than their gold, so. Or, well, let's see. About 10 seconds better than their gold. So most likely not going to be PBing today, but is going to be very much in range of that PB. Again, the Moon Cave skip and heading into the chapel. Crazy facial reactions from Ghetto as they start off this Bowser's fight. Setting back up for the one jump. Oh, Okay, no, not a wall and waddle jump, just a regular moon caves kick. Okay, Civ, Ghetto into the 2D section. Oh, nearly dying from 2D skip. Gets it on second attempt. That, we can all breathe a sigh of relief. Okay, Ghetto gonna be getting into the pillars, finishing out pillars, gonna be getting a 104.44 according to the run.gg. Well done for Ghetto Otaku, getting within 20 seconds of their PB and moving on to the finals for Division C. Okay, Civ's entering Pillar's room. Gonna be looking to be getting a 106, probably. Well, definitely a 106, but somewhere, you know, like something 106, maybe like 106.1x. We'll see. Okay, Sibs with the 106.09. GG's to both players. We'll see if either wants to come in for interviews. Sibs already in the waiting room. And there's Ghetto Otaku. All right. Hello, players.
Hello, GG's Otaku.
GG's. oh wait, hold on. I have this remote. Okay. I got so lucky.
No, it's a. I mean, you played very well. I mean, playing that close off your PB isn't easy in a race. So
I played very well. I don't know how, but I didn't get salt triple, and I played it safe for the most part. But I somehow goaded luncheon. That helped.
Oh really?
Yeah, I missed the cycle too. In my PB, I swear I got like the Potaboo cycle. I don't know how that goaded. I'll have to watch it back.
Yeah, that's crazy.
I also goaded luncheon.
Again?
Yeah.
Back to back?
Yeah, yeah.
Nice.
Oh, I got so lucky. You're so good at it. You're so shit. So nasty.
It pretty much was just set once.
The deep woods.
Yeah.
Once yeah. It really was.
I gave up after sand because of how terrible my CCS was. That's why I went for late clip, because I don't normally go for late clip. So I gave up. I was just like, I lost here. And then I saw that you fell into deep woods. I was like, oh, that's nice.
Yeah, now that was unfortunate. I can just play safe. Yeah.
I can just play completely safe and like, there's no way I'm going to lose, really.
Yeah, no, that was definitely the play.
That might have made 104 easier, honestly. You know, having that weight off your shoulders and just knowing just got to play consistent and not have to.
Yeah, for sure. Because originally, since my CCS was so bad, I was going to go for ICC.
What?
I was going to go for yellow ICC. But yeah, I saw that. What is it? I was ahead. I was just like, I'm just going to.
Yeah, yeah. No, I mean, that fall in deep woods was basically the decider, I think.
That was, yeah.
I made a few small mistakes here and there otherwise, but like, yeah, that was, I couldn't make up the time from that.
I'm actually kind of surprised because when you fell into deep woods, I'm pretty sure you weren't that far behind me after wooded, right?
No, I was like 50 something seconds behind. And then after loss, I think I was like 40 something, but then I kept messing up after that and it just all went downhill.
Really? I thought because didn't you get Snowdrift first try? Or
I did, yeah.
Yeah, I'm surprised you didn't make up like a good amount of time in snow then.
It didn't save that much because I died earlier in snow.
Yeah, that's what happened.
In the typhoon room.
Yeah.
Oh really? That's tough.
Yeah. I got like a weird jump off of like I like accidentally hit the railing at the start or something. I couldn't get my jump correct. Aww. So I just like fumbled from there. So
nah, because I was still scared even going to sand because I was like, I'm not going to go for Snowdrift anymore since I'm so ahead. But if he gets Snowdrift, I feel like there's still a good chance that he could make it back.
Yeah.
But
yeah, I would have been a lot closer if not for Monka Deep Woods, and I also don't know what to do down there.
Yeah, you just got the nut and noped out of there real fast.
I was like, oh, this
Clip, right?
Yeah, I got enough clip, and then I bonked trying to get the out of bounds moon.
Yeah,
like, did you even get the out of bounds moon? Or
no.
That's tough.
Yeah, so I had to do the story moon too. It was a rough wooded. I lost like 2 minutes to my goal. But like when I fell down there, I was like, oh, this seed spot is like right next to where I fell. It must go right next to the tree moon, right?
Nope.
No.
Nope.
Nope.
Goes right next to the Odyssey. Yep.
Yeah. I need to figure out what to do in there for next race. If I fall.
I feel like if you fall into deep woods, I feel there's not much you can do really.
No.
And like in that spot. But if you fall into deep woods, like what is it? After nut around the corner, that's not bad because you can just get like two moons really quick in deep woods and then just go back up to the Odyssey.
True.
But
yeah, I really don't blame people for not knowing backups for deep woods.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah, like because
if you fall in deep woods, that's a reset.
Right. If I fall in deep woods in a run, I'm resetting. Like I'm not messing with that.
Every time. Yeah.
Yeah. For sure. Well, GG's, man. You played very well. Very consistent.
If it wasn't for that one singular mistake,
I know, like, dude. That literally, like, the losing the 2 minutes, literally, it would have got me like a low to mid 104 if I didn't fall into deep woods. I think.
Yeah, for sure. GG's.
GG's, man. Good luck in finals.
I'm gonna need it.
Who are you gonna be up against?
Let's see. Fighting the winner of Tanini. I don't know how to pronounce their names, by the way, but I believe is pronounced Tanini versus Kog. Kog has a Kog. Has a 103, a mid 103.
Oh shit.
Yeah.
Just hope for the best. Hope you just play consistent. Hope for the best.
I'm gonna need them to do what you did and wouldn't. Yeah. Unless that happens, I have zero chance of winning.
Yeah. No, you got this, I believe.
Thanks, man. Thanks.
Okay, so with that, we're gonna be moving on to the next race. GG's to both of you. Congratulations on GG's. Moving on to finals.
Yeah.
For Div C. But don't go anywhere because we got Div A race coming up next. The Fletch versus SA1102 SMO. Mouthful. But yeah. See you then. Bye.
GG's.
GG's.